Hey mamas, happy Tuesday. Welcome to my Facebook Live. Today we are going to be talking about this book called, it's probably backwards for you guys, but Parenting from the Inside Out. So I finished this awesome book, the sun is like right in my face here. Finished this awesome book and I really just wanted to give it a quick review for you guys for whether or not you should read this as a new mom. And I really honestly totally enjoyed this book. It was a little bit of a harder read, only because it uses very strong psychological language and uses a lot of like neuroscience language. So my first downside to this book was that it was a difficult read. I have a background in psychology, so it made it a little bit easier for me. But if you don't have a strong science background, it is a little bit of a struggle to read. They have these little blurbs inside called Spotlight on Science, and it basically gives you a little bit more insight into the science of what they're talking about in the book. So if you are not savvy with scientific language, I would suggest that when you get to the end of the chapter, you just skip over that part because it is a little bit of a struggle to understand. But for the most part, the book will give you great insights. So again, if you're struggling with the scientific language, I would either get it on audio or just read the parts that, you know, are specific to what you're going through right now. But to give you a little bit of an overview of this book, especially for a new mom, I really enjoyed the fact that they basically tell you to look at yourself and what you've experienced as a child and how you were parented, and then how those subconscious negative beliefs come up again in your parenting. So this goes a lot of what I teach. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Danielle Cotis. I am a new mom coach and I coach new expectant and toddler moms how to make this transition into motherhood. So this book really works on the same basis that I do, is that you're looking at your past in order to not repeat it. So for example, you'll see in parenting, especially as a new mom, that as things surface with your babies and your toddlers, you'll find yourself repeating some of the things that your parents said when you were smaller. And you'll find yourself saying, oh my God, I sound like my mother, or oh my God, I sound like my father, or oh my God, this is something my mom would do, or something my dad would do, or whatever caretaker you had when you were small. You find yourself doing those things that they did when they were parenting you. So what it talks about is learning that the ways that you were parented may not have been the best ways that you were parented. Now, it doesn't mean that your parents were wrong. It just means that they were just given those tools, and whatever tools they had is how they parented. So how we know how to parent is from our parents and their parents before them and so on and so forth. So what ends up happening is the cycle keeps repeating itself. So we, I don't want to say are doomed to repeat it, repeat the past, but if you're not conscious of the fact that this is an actual scientifically proven that we parent very similar to the way our parents parent. And if you didn't really enjoy the way you were parented, or you didn't find that a lot of things align with how you want to parent your children, then you need to become aware of those parenting concerns that you have that your parents parented you with. So it talks a lot about how you can rewrite your story and how you can get to the point where you are not doomed to repeat the same mistakes as your parents and as their parents repeated those mistakes from theirs and so on and so forth. So it's more about becoming aware and how those things that your parents taught you may affected you and how it will affect your children. So if you find that you have, you know, some sort of low self-esteem, or you are feeling unworthy or undeserving, or you have anxiety or depression, a lot of that stems from how you were parented. And again, we're not blaming our parents for the mistakes they made. Again, they were only given so many tools, and that's what they use to parent you with. So it's about changing those beliefs and those actions and learning how to change them for the better of your child and for the better of you. So again, it's parenting yourself before parenting your child. So if you have a quick temper or you're quick to get sad, they talk about a lot of things that arise in parents as they are parenting. So I'll give you an example from my life, and something similar to Dr. Siegel's is that, you know, he walks into his screaming baby and he, you know, has this intent to shake the baby. And he's trying to figure out where this is coming from, where this anger or uncomfortability is coming from, and why he has this initial way to shake the baby, because the crying becomes this an annoyance, and it brings up all these ugly emotions. So it's about finding where that's coming from. And in his case, in the book, it came from a time when he was in pediatrics and he was dealing with a lot of crying kids, and he had to, you know, do his job and, you know, hold the kids down and give them shots and things like that, and how it traumatized him. So it's not only always from your parents. It could be from any point in your life that where it causes this turmoil in you. So it's finding out what is causing that reaction in you, this subconscious reaction, because when we're conscious and we're not sleep deprived and we're not tired or anxious or angry, we respond differently. So it's those times when we're stressed out, when we're sleep deprived, and all these ugly emotions are coming up. It's finding where that is coming from and learning where this is coming from and changing that and moving forward, so we get to the point where we can respond to our child in the proper way and not in this action where we're gonna shake our babies, or we're gonna scream, or we're gonna hit them, or whatever it is, because these ugly emotions are stemming from somewhere. And it's about this emotional baggage that we carry our whole lives and we never really get through it. And learning how to get to the point where we notice these things and getting through them and processing these emotions, because if we don't process them early on, later on we'll have trouble with our children and we won't have great relationships. And, you know, I'm sure in your life you will see that maybe you are struggling with some relationships with certain parents, you know, either your mom or your dad or both of them, or whatever caregivers you had. You know, you might have some resentment towards them, and it could be as small as you were left to cry for long periods of time, or that your parents went back to work earlier than normal. It could be that they yelled a lot, that they weren't there for you when you needed them. It could be so many different things that have caused these ugly emotions, but it's learning how to process these emotions and get through them. So if we're able to do that, then we can parent from a more loving and conscious point of view, so that our kids can be the best versions of themselves by us being the best versions of ourselves. So inside, they basically go step by step, you know, about what different experiences that you might have gone through and how to overcome them. And at the end of each chapter, they have what they call inside out exercises, and they basically go through different scenarios and how you can you know, journal through these and actual tips and steps to get through whatever it is that is causing you this kind of, you know, excess traumatizing emotions that are coming through with your kids. So I do suggest that you do the inside out exercises. They're great. It's awesome. But overall, I really enjoyed this book, and it really made me look more into myself, even though I've already done that. This actually causes you to look even deeper inside of your emotional trauma that's happened over your lifespan, and kind of how to deal with that and get rid of that emotional baggage so that you can parent the best way that you possibly can for your kids. And it'll make you a better person for it. You know, it'll make you feel lighter and less stress and less guilty about your actions, and you'll be able to take better action steps based on this book. So I give the book 4 stars. The only reason I give it 4 stars is it's difficult. If you are not scientifically savvy with words, it is a difficult read. So I would suggest you get the audiobook so that it's a little bit easier to read. Otherwise I would have given it 5 stars just because the book is that good. So 4 stars it is. Sorry, Dr. Siegel. 4 stars you get. I hope at one point in time they make a smaller version. I don't want to say for dummies, because that's not sounds right, but I wish it was a little bit well written for the average Joe, because what we are average Joes. We are average people, average moms. And we need to know this stuff. We need to learn about ourselves, and we need to learn about our emotional baggage, and we need to process that so that we can be the best parents we can be. But I do suggest that anybody, if you're expecting, especially if you're a new mom, if you're expecting, this is the best time to read it. If you're a toddler mom, definitely find the time to sit down and read it. You will see that your kids are picking up every single thing that you do, good or bad. So you want to make sure that you are finding the best version of yourself, so your kids are picking up the best version, and you will find that they will start acting differently when you are acting differently. When you are acting as the best version of yourself, they will start doing the same. So this is definitely a toddler mom book, an expectant mother book. If you're in that first year, you might find it hard to read this book, or maybe it won't necessarily pertain to you until toddlerhood. But if you are struggling, like I did with the postpartum depression and anxiety, this is definitely something to read. And you will find that yourself crying a little bit, because you will see that some of the things that happened in your childhood, even though they don't seem that traumatic, maybe they were that traumatic towards you. And you will see that, you know, it's not necessarily you that has the problem. It's just that this baggage that you're holding on to is hovering over your head and causing you this emotional turmoil. So if you can learn to get through that, then this postpartum depression, anxiety, the identity crisis, all that stuff will start to melt away. But I do suggest you do the inside out exercises, you know, and develop what Dr. Siegel calls mindsight. You know, becoming aware of your thoughts, becoming aware of this trauma that you've had, and using it for the better. So 4 stars, Dr. Siegel. I loved it. Thank you so much. Thank you all for being on the line with me. Thank you for all the people on the replay. Hey guys, give me a like if you like this review. Please share in your mom groups. This is a great book, Parenting from the Inside Out. I will be doing at least 1 book review a month for you guys, so you know which ones are the books that you should read and ones that you probably should stay away from. And we'll do anything from, you know, the shit no one tells you, that book, to, you know, the conscious parents. So I'm trying to get a widespread book reviews for you guys, so you know which ones are the right ones for you. So thank you all so much. If you don't already like my Facebook page, please do, The Unfamiliar Mom. I'm Danielle Kotis, and I will see you next time. Thank you guys. Have a great day.